Hey guys, how's it going? Mike Vasile here, and in this video, we're talking about Amazon FBA, what it is, and how beginners can earn anywhere from $100 to $700 per day. More with that after the intro. Hey guys, how's it going? Mike Vasile here. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, I remind you that several spots have opened up for this week's free workshop, where it's the fastest and easiest way to make money online. Sign up for it in the link below. So I got started with Amazon FBA around 2012, 2013 with my dad because we just wanted to make money online. You know, we wanted to provide for our family, pay off our debt, and to finally create freedom for ourselves. And that's why me and like 2 million other people decided to start making money with Amazon FBA. But the problem with most people, when they hear about Amazon, they're like, what is it? What are the benefits? What are the disadvantages? Is it good for beginners? Is it safe for beginners? Can I lose a bunch of money? In this video, we're going to reveal all of that and find out if it's still a good opportunity to get started, especially as a complete newbie this year. So all Amazon FBA means, it stands for Fulfillment by Amazon. So essentially, you do all of the hard work with finding the right products and doing the research and thinking what products people might want to buy on Amazon. And then you kind of like just package it up, put it nice and pretty, and just send it off to Amazon. It's pretty simple. You know, that's the big selling point that got me. I was like, Dad, we literally just got to go to and buy these products from China, ship them over to Amazon, and Amazon will do all of the work and we'll just get paid every 2 weeks. It was the dream life or the dream vision or the dream idea of an online business, to set it up once and to never forget it. And this is essentially how it works. You go to a company like Alibaba and you would go ahead and just type in grill mats, right? And this is exactly what I did when I was gonna sell grill mats. And as you can see, you see so many different grill mats over here that people use to go and sell on Amazon. So what I would do is I would kind of like chat now and just kind of like talking to these people from China. The funny thing is all of these people are literally from China, so their English is kind of like a little broken, but nonetheless, they're still very effective when it comes to communicating exactly what they need from you, especially what you need from them to go and give you high quality products. Now, once you have that, you wanna go and create a brand around it. So what I would do is just type in logo design on Fiverr. And you could create a simple logo design here, like for like $15 or $25. You could literally send it to the people in China and they would print your logo or your design kind of like this on the actual grill mat or whatever product that you actually want to go ahead and buy. The moment you brand it, you literally just go and place the order and send it directly to where you live or whatever. Especially when you're just getting started, you want to see the product if it's actually good. The moment you have that, you want to go ahead and hire what is known as Amazon photography so that they can take like professional photos of it, because these are the photos that are going to go ahead and eventually sell on Amazon. As you can see right here, they're all like these professional images and whatnot. You could simply hire it out for someone getting started with that. Then when someone goes over to Amazon and buys this actual product, Amazon directly ships it to the customer. You don't deal with customer service. You don't deal with customer complaints. You don't deal with returns. And just like that, you get paid every 2 weeks. And you really only have three responsibilities. Number one, choosing the right product. Number two, keeping it in stock. And number three, marketing. So number one, choosing the right product is the most important thing. I spent a bunch of money on dog leashes and it was a horrible product. Like no one ended up actually buying it for me, right? So just like that, that was my fault. That's not Amazon's fault. Number two, I had to make sure the inventory was good. When I was running out of grill mats, I always needed to make sure that I would reorder from my supplier and ship it back to Amazon before it would actually go ahead and run out of stock. Because the moment it runs out of stock, you lose your rankings in like the search algorithm, like when people are searching for it on Amazon. Like for example, you know these keywords that come up, grill mat and all of these things, these are how people are making money. They rank a specific word with the product, and because of that, that's exactly how they make money with these things. The moment you're out of stock, you know, this starts kind of going further back all the way to, I don't know, like page 14 or whatnot. And no one ever goes to that, like how no one ever goes to the second page of Google. If the product doesn't sell well on Amazon and you already have all of these products, guess what? You can't just have an automatic do-over. You have to figure out how to market it. There's like literally advertising and like agencies that you could work with to actually go ahead and do that. Now that we know all of that, let's talk about the benefits and the disadvantages, because that's probably what you're here on this video for. You wanna know, is this gonna be a good business for me or not? Well, the number one thing is the passive income idea, okay? Theoretically, you can get a really good product that just so happens to do well and make a bunch of money from it and never have to worry about that ever again. My friend actually does that with coffee mugs
relationships.
This is literally all he sells. He sells like coffee mugs, like with this thing on here, and he just has a bunch of different things, right? Because a lot of people are afraid to go ahead and go to this because it's like a breakable thing, but he kills it from Amazon, just creating all of these interesting things with state mugs to, you know, like these things. And he's doing really well with that because it's stable, it's consistent. There's not a lot of competitors because a lot of people are going and afraid to buying like breakable thing in products. That's actually what a lot of people that start Amazon FBA tell you not to do. But he was like, screw it, there's no competition here. I'm just gonna go ahead and sell breakable products, right? So for his case, he does all right for himself and he does really well because it's been consistent. Also, it's really big into the holiday theme, right? So a lot of these people are giving them as gifts, so they don't deal with returns, right? So he's actually making really good money from that. And it's pretty passive. You know, all the times before a big holiday, he just has to go to a supplier and get a good amount of money and a good amount of stock available for Amazon because he knows his numbers, okay? That's one of the benefits when you've been doing it for years. You know exactly how much is actually gonna go ahead and sell. The second thing is there's already millions of people already searching for things on Amazon. Like if I just type things in, you literally see, okay, if these are what's showing up, this is what people are actually looking for in terms of coffee mugs. If I go over here too, there's coffee mugs for men, coffee mugs for women, coffee mugs funny. All of these things people are actively looking for right now when it comes to making money with Amazon. And as you can see, here are all these people that are just selling coffee mugs that are doing it well. There's already millions that are already looking for that. The benefit of doing this compared to like having your own store is no one's searching for your store because your store is just new or it doesn't exist yet. Amazon has the credibility. They have the trust. They've been around for like a long, long, long time. People trust Amazon. So you get to leverage Amazon and make money from that. And of course, the big thing is quick delivery. So customers are happy. If they enjoy your product, they're gonna buy more of your products. Another thing is no logistics. You don't have, like, I owned an e-commerce business back in the day and it was very annoying to deal with logistics of returns and customer complaints and dealing with suppliers and manufacturers. And it was just so much for me that I was like, oh wow, like I really miss Amazon FBA, especially that aspect of things. Now let's talk about the disadvantages, right? Number one, I didn't realize how much people I needed to hire, okay? Because you think it's just good to like, oh, buy products in China, send it to Amazon, you're rich. It's not the case. You're gonna have to hire a lot of people. Like one of them is like Amazon PPC. This stands for pay per click. Now, if I go over here, you'll notice some of these are sponsored, right? You literally have to pay someone to figure this out for you, especially if you're not an advertiser yourself, right? So I didn't know that I had to spend more money to advertise products that are already on Amazon, okay? People think it's just set and forget. No, you have to start running advertising to it, especially if you don't have any reviews. Like this person doesn't have any reviews, that's why they have to run ads to it. So you literally have to hire someone like from Pakistan for like $4 an hour or whatnot, and sometimes they're not really that good. Sometimes you could go even higher for $15 an hour. Like with this Hamid Z guy, maybe they might do a better job, but you're gonna have to deal with hiring if you're not smart when it comes to all these things like how I was. Another thing that you also have to do is SEO. SEO stands for search engine optimization. Now what you notice, I just typed in coffee mugs funny, right? This is a keyword that people are actively using to go and search things. Right, but if they don't have it in their name, then how are people ever gonna find you, right? You need, like for example, for me with grill mats, you could see all these things, grill mats for decks, for large grill mats, for outdoor grill. I'm just gonna type in grill mats. If you notice and you pull up anything, you notice this thing right here, nonstick BBQ mat, gas charcoal electric grilling accessories, outdoor barbecue baking sheet. Those are all keywords. Guess what? To sell on Amazon, you need to at least get good at that, or you need to figure out how to hire that out as well. And as you guys can see, you know, you could hire from like Bangladesh for like $12 an hour, right? The disadvantages is you gotta understand that building an Amazon FBA business isn't just like a one-man show. You need to have like an entire business around it, especially if you wanna go ahead and sell it. And with that, you need to understand how to actually hire people, which like for me, I was like, I'm not really good with managing people and whatnot, and it's kind of like hard on me and stuff.
And another complicated thing with Amazon are the taxes, because the sales tax with all the different states are completely different, and it's also like an accounting nightmare, right? I'm really curious, what do you think your advantages and disadvantages are when you think of Amazon FBA as a business model? Comment below. Also, if you want a faster and easier way to make money online, check out the free workshop below, where this is even a faster way to make money than Amazon FBA. And also, if you're new to the channel, make sure you check out and subscribe to the podcast. We interview a bunch of multimillionaires that have made millions of dollars doing things other than Amazon FBA. Check it out in the second link below. With that being said, I'll see you guys later. You.